Right now, Wisconsin sets a new daily record for coronavirus cases as we head into the last weekend before Dane County's mask mandate.
And a local community marks 2 years since tragedy. How some prairie is trying to move forward as it faces new challenges.
The showers and thunderstorms of yesterday are moving out, but perhaps some cooler air is moving in.
This is News 3 Now This Morning.
And good Friday morning to you. It is July 10th, 2020. I'm Chris Stanford.
And I'm Leah Lynchine. Thanks for joining us on your Friday. Some parts of the viewing area are waking up to widespread damage this morning. Trees down, homes damaged, and more.
Sauk Prairie police say officials responded to multiple calls of roadways blocked, power lines and service lines ripped from homes, and power outages in that area yesterday evening. Police say some homes have minor damage from trees falling on them. Our crews talked with one person who heard one of those trees come down.
On the front porch, I could hear some snapping, and then I heard a big crack. It's like, something went down.
Well, flooding has been an issue in Sauk Prairie. The main concern last night was from all the wind.
Okay, take a second and look up from whatever you're doing to take a look at this. This is from strong storms in Rock County yesterday.
Whoa!
Unbelievable video. Lori Blank from Janesville sent this to us. It's a doorbell video that catches a very close call.
Man.
You can call it that. The tree comes within inches of that gentleman. Luckily, it appears he wasn't hurt. I just watched this over and over when this came into our tips email. I mean, it is unbelievable.
It's very compelling.
You can see the power lines come down with it there, too. I mean, he literally was like, I mean, he had to be brushed by that.
Man. Scary.
Wow. Well, guys, check out this new video into the newsroom this morning as well, sent to us by Chad Schlamp. He says this was taken just east of Arena. You can see a series of power poles snapped and just laying on the ground. Overnight, Alliant Energy reported about 30 customers without power in that area, but within the last couple of hours, Alliant says the lights should be back on for those folks this morning. Well, Chris Reese was telling us about it yesterday. He was kind of giving us the little preview. You were out tracking it last night, and it was really a wild night.
It was a wild night. Probably one of my favorite nights in a long time from being just a weather tracker per se, but all week long I talked about how hot and humid it was, how hot and humid it was, how hot and humid it was. That's just fuel for big thunderstorms, Josh. And when you let it build up, when something comes along to unzip it, you get explosive thunderstorms. That's exactly what we saw yesterday, and some of the remnants are still here. The fire, per se, is not yet out, as we still have at least some showers lingering through the area, but sunshine is getting ready to make a return. We are watching the showers in Dane County start to move away from us. We had one down around Stoughton and McFarland. That's now starting to move into parts of Jefferson and Rock counties. Towards the north and west, we've had a shower that we've been watching, but this is now starting to move over towards the Milwaukee Retro, and now we have one shower that's coming into Janesville right now. That's going to be pulling away as we go through time. Here's the big picture. Some heavier rain up between Green Bay and Appleton. That's starting to move out. It's just some lingering showers back towards the west. As those pull away, it will be a return of the sunshine today. We're already starting to see some of that around here. We like it. 67 at the airport right now. One little shower coming down at Dane County Regional. So with that being said, this is about it. This might be the last little bout of rain that we have today. 67 in Lone Rock as well. Janesville at 68. Good morning to Monroe coming in at 66. Here are the dew points, though. They are down from yesterday, but they're still a little bit humid. There's still going to be enough moisture in the atmosphere that your hair begins to frizz as you step outside. Let's put things into motion as we go throughout your morning now. This is 12:30, lunchtime. Temperatures are into the upper 70s to right around 80. But there's sunshine at this point. Those winds continue out of the north and west. We top out at 85 today. Overnight tonight, areas towards the south and west of Madison have the chance to get in on a little shower as those overnight lows fall down into the 60s. Then tomorrow, it's the mid-80s for those highs. A slight chance of an afternoon shower, but most of the day should wind up being dry. This is the pattern as we go into next week. The core of the heat is back towards the south and west. We get in on some cooler air coming in from the north and west, but eventually, as we go through the week ahead, we're going to ride that space between where you have your cooler air towards the north, your warmer air towards the south that keeps those temperatures a little bit closer to normal, but we're going to be watching at least a chance for some showers and thunderstorms, especially on Tuesday and Wednesday. The heat starts to build back up, though, starting on Thursday.
All right, Chris, thank you. Breaking overnight, Madison police need your help in finding a woman they say walked out of Meritor Hospital. This is Mary Benham. She was last seen leaving Meritor around 4:30 yesterday afternoon. We're told she doesn't have access to a cell phone or vehicle, and there are some concerns that she may be unsafe on her own. She was wearing a dark blue jacket or sweater, a flowery short skirt, light gray pants, and blue leather flats. She was also carrying a purse and a plastic bag. If you've seen her, you're asked to call Madison Police at the number on your screen. That's 608-255-2345.
We're a few hours away from new coronavirus numbers from the local health department after Wisconsin once again set a new single-day case record for positive cases, for cases total. 739 additional cases were confirmed yesterday. That pushes the statewide total now to more than 34,000. The percentage of tests that came back positive stayed relatively steady at 5.7%. We are expecting updated numbers from Dane County at about 9:30 this morning.
The World Health Organization says there's growing evidence the virus can easily linger and spread indoors. That's leading to growing concerns about worker safety in places like meatpacking plants. Workers' rights groups in Iowa are filing a complaint against Tyson Foods and JBS, claiming they're putting profits before people. The complaint says those companies' current policies don't allow for 6 feet of separation between workstations because it would lower the amount of meat the plant could process in a day.
Clearly, JBS, Tyson, Smithfield, and the others, I mean, they're doing the things that look good as far as window dressing goes, but they're not really getting to the most specific things, one of which is the social distancing. Can they do that? Of course they can do that.
So the groups filing the complaint want Ag Secretary Sonny Perdue to force the companies to follow CDC guidelines. Tyson says they take the safety of their employees seriously and they are reviewing that complaint.
New interim president of the UW system, former Governor Tommy Thompson, says he is still dedicated to reopening campuses this fall. He made those comments during his first Board of Regents meeting yesterday. He's also requesting $110 million from Governor Tony Evers to pay for COVID-19 tests, contact tracing, and PPE for all of the UW system's 26 campuses. The Board of Regents also unanimously passed a rule requiring masks to be worn inside all UW system buildings. Thompson says there's no way to reopen campuses safely without the mandate. The policy also encourages wearing a mask outside when social distancing is impossible. UW-Madison had already announced a similar policy themselves, but the vote means every UW campus will now have to follow the rules.
6:07, your time now. Most people in and around Sun Prairie know exactly where they were 2 years ago today. Around 6:15 p.m. on July 10th, 2018, crews hit a gas line while working downtown. 40 minutes later, that triggered a building leveling explosion, sending a massive ball of fire into the air.
The community quickly learned that one of its own, Captain Corey Barr, had died in the fire that followed. Now, 2 years later, Sun Prairie leaders are working to rebuild their community and remember their captain. Christina Laurie is in Sun Prairie this morning and spoke with some city leaders about what's planned for today. Good morning, Christina.
Good morning, everyone. Sun Prairie Mayor Paul Esser is no stranger to adversity. He's been in charge of Wisconsin's second fastest growing city. That's right, Sun Prairie is Wisconsin's second fastest growing city over the course of 5 decades. And now he's leading this community through a new challenge, a global pandemic. And he's finding one common thread between the two events, and that is resiliency. He says the 2018 explosion taught him how important that is and how much of it his community already has. He explains that both 2 years ago and today he's witnessed the incredible bravery of Sun Prairie's first responders and everyday people working for the best of their community without asking why, and he knows he's not alone. However, Mayor Esser has found one stark difference between the coronavirus pandemic and the 2018 explosion, and that's time. The July explosion was a single event that caused most of its destruction in just a few hours, leaving the community to deal with its aftermath. The pandemic, though, has been an ongoing threat, causing the community to grapple with what's happening now and while remaining unsure of what could happen next. Now, speaking of what's next, Sun Prairie is still in the process of rebuilding. There are a number of housing projects, apartment complexes, and even a building here at the explosion site in the works. One project, though, has been complete. That's a memorial tribute and a statue to Captain Corey Barr. It'll be dedicated tonight at 6 o'clock. We are going to learn more about that statue coming up in about 30 minutes. And I also do want to point out the tribute that just went up behind me in a matter of minutes. A man was out here putting that up just shortly after 6 a.m. and it really shows how much this community really cares about what happened here and how fresh these memories are still 2 years later. Chris and Leah.
Yeah, that's a day that city won't forget, a day our newsroom certainly won't forget either. Christina Laurie, thank you.
All right, let's take a look at your traffic. Coming up on 610 this Friday morning, we'll take a look at the Madison maps right now. No crashes to report. Looks like a few slowdowns on Stoughton Road South as you approach the Beltline. Park Street seeing a little bit more volume, and you're hopping on the Beltline this morning. Looks like you are moving at posted speeds. That's your first one traffic.
Coming up, after facing criticism for the way they handled protests and riots at the end of May, Madison's police chief says he's going outside the organization to review their practices.
And if there's going to be college sports in the fall, the Badgers going to be limiting their travel. We're taking a closer look at their decision to play only Big Ten games and the effects that might have. That's when News 3 Now this morning returns.
Whatever your water worry, Culligan Water can help. With over 40 filtration systems, all NSF certified, including the world's best softener, no one filters more than Culligan Water, the only water that comes with a van. Contact Culligan, the local water experts.
Here's to the road ahead. Trust Toyota to be here for you.
The best new cars make the best used cars. That's why every Toyota certified used vehicle gets a 160-point inspection, new warranty starting the day you purchase, 1 year of roadside assistance, and more. Get as low as 0% APR financing on select Toyota certified used models. See your dealer for details.
All from the brand you trust, today and tomorrow, Toyota.
I love to equal the playing field. I love to help people and allow them to feel like they are powerful instead of powerless. We're with our clients every step of the way.
Gingras Thompson and Walks.
Joe Biden has never been president for some very good reasons.
Where did you place in that class?
One of them is still breathtaking years later.
I think I probably have a much higher IQ than you do, I suspect. I went to law school on a full academic scholarship, the only one in my class, and in fact ended up in the top half of my class. I was the outstanding student in the political science department at the end of my year. I graduated with 3 degrees, and I'd be delighted to sit down and compare my IQ to yours if you'd like, Frank.
Really, Joe?
Biden now concedes he did not graduate in the top half of his law school class, that he does not have 3 degrees from college, and that he was not named outstanding political science student in college.
Newsweek says Biden actually went to school on a half scholarship, ended up near the bottom of his class, and won only 1 degree, not 3.
Now Biden says Newsweek is right. His memory had failed him.
Joe Biden, unsuited then, unsuited now. Restoration Pack is responsible for the content of his advertising.
If someone came to you and asked, what are you invested in? Would your answer be about mutual funds and money markets? Or would it be mutual relationships and farmers markets? Maybe both. At Thrivent, we believe money is a tool, not a goal. And with the right guidance, it can afford you a life rich in meaning and gratitude. By gaining financial clarity today, you can thrive with purpose tomorrow. Talk to a Thrivent financial professional or visit Thrivent.com.
Incredible deals, huge markdowns, plus free doorstep shipping on everything. What a sale. The 4th of July sale at Slumberland Furniture.
We're back. Madison Interim Police Chief Vic Wall says he's having an outside group take a look at the way his department handled protests in the days following the death of George Floyd. In a Facebook post, Wall says he's reaching out to the Quattron Center for the Fair Administration of Justice at the University of Pennsylvania's Law School for an independent look at the police response. Madison police have faced criticism for their use of tear gas in the first days of the protest. Wall says the group will look at both how the department reacted to the protests and what led to the response.
A Middleton man is now facing multiple charges as a result of the looting that stemmed from those protests. Madison police arrested 21-year-old Noah Riek yesterday. They say they identified him using surveillance photos taken the nights of May 30th and 31st. He faces charges of burglary and criminal damage to property for allegedly looting knuckleheads and Under Armour, as well as allegedly throwing a construction horse through a window at Manchester Place. Madison police say they are continuing to go through surveillance video to identify and arrest more people responsible for that damage.
An activist being accused of threatening damage to downtown businesses has now been indicted in federal court. A grand jury indicted 28-year-old Devonier Johnson on two counts of extortion yesterday. Prosecutors accused him of trying to get money and food from those businesses by threatening property damage. Johnson faces a maximum sentence of 20 years on each count if he's convicted. Johnson's public arrest last month led to more protests, which saw the statues outside of the state capitol torn down.
We are learning more about an active hate crime investigation here in Madison. Last month, a black woman says a group of white men threw lighter fluid on her and then lit her on fire. Through an open records request, News 3 Now has obtained an audio file of the call where Althea Bernstein reported the incident to police.
Yeah, I was driving in my car to Middleton, and I heard like a group of people yell the N-word, and I turned my head and they threw lighter fluid at me and then threw a like match or lighter at me.
Madison police say they are continuing to work on the case with the assistance of the FBI. There is still a $10,000 reward for information that leads to an arrest.
Hate crime charges are being filed against a man accused of intentionally running into another man on a motorcycle because he was white. Daniel Navarro told detectives he intentionally hit Philip Tyson head-on last Friday night because Tyson was riding a Harley, and Navarro believed the so-called Harley culture was made up of white racists. The two never met before the incident. Navarro had his initial court appearance yesterday and claimed he was being taunted by others because he's Hispanic and felt he needed to kill people he thought were racist.
A breaking update overnight this morning, the death of a black man found hanging in a tree in California is being ruled a suicide. The body of 24-year-old Robert Fuller was found in the early morning hours about a month ago in Los Angeles County. His belongings were the only thing found at the scene. Authorities originally ruled the death a suicide, but reopened the case after public concerns he was possibly lynched. The LA County Sheriff's Department says the additional investigation found no signs of a struggle or signs that Fuller tried to remove the rope.
Local leaders are teaming up to encourage black business startups here in Madison. Dane County officials announced $100,000 in county funds will be going toward the Urban League of Greater Madison. That money is going to be used to create an economic development hub on Madison's south side. It will also be used to create a project development position, which Representative Sheila Stubbs says is critical.
We as elected officials should be able to help prevent gentrification in South Madison. And this is the absolute first step. And this is what we call the initial step in preventing gentrification. And this project position is exactly what it looks like.
The development is planned for the South Park Street corridor.
617 right now, Chris Reese out on the patio with a look at your forecast. And this is the first morning in like weeks that I'm actually quite jealous of you right now, Chris.
It feels good. It feels good. There's a breeze. So even though there's still a little bit of humidity out here, that breeze is really making a difference for us. That air's a lot cooler. It doesn't feel as stale and stagnant after the showers and thunderstorms from yesterday. So it's literally like a breath of fresh air as we begin to step outside. Here's a look from our tower camera facing the west. There's still a couple of beautiful clouds out on the horizon. That is the rain starting to move on away from us right now. This last batch of rain is starting to move out of Wisconsin over Lake Michigan and towards the north and east. That will be replaced with sunshine as we go through time. Still a few raindrops coming down at the airport, but we are drying out. 67 is the temperature. Janesville is at 68. You're at 64 as you work your way up towards the Dalles and 66 in Wautoma. As we look ahead throughout the day, though, folks, we're going to hit the 70s rather quickly once the sun truly begins to shine. 78 as we get you later on into the morning. 80 by lunch will top out at 85.
And Chris, thank you.
My pleasure.
618. Madison's representative in Congress is taking American Airlines to task over their return to booking full flights. The airline recently announced they would resume selling middle seats, basically doing away with distancing on their planes. In a tweet overnight, Mark Pocan said that this was all a sign of corporate greed over passenger safety. According to the Journal Sentinel, Pocan sent a letter to the CEO of American Airlines criticizing them for taking federal CARES Act money before announcing this new policy. American Airlines requires most passengers to wear face masks and says they believe their policy is still safe.
Some of those flights may be headed to Orlando this weekend as Disney World is scheduled to reopen. It's been closed for more than 110 days due to the pandemic, but it'll start its reopening process on Saturday. That's when Magic Kingdom and Animal Kingdom will reopen to visitors. Epcot and Hollywood Studios are scheduled to reopen next Wednesday. Now, these plans come as Florida continues to experience a big spike in COVID cases, with more than 230,000 cases and more than 4,000 deaths.
If college sports happen in the fall, the Badgers will only be playing schools in the Big Ten. That conference decided all fall sports, and includes football, volleyball, men's, women's soccer, men's and women's cross country. They'll all shift to a conference-only model this fall. That means the Badgers' highly anticipated football game against Notre Dame at Lambeau Field won't be happening this year. The decision could create a snowball effect in college football, with more conferences possibly following suit in the coming weeks.
I'm still just holding out hope that we have some sort of football season.
I think you and a lot of other people out there are holding on to that hope. We keep seeing all these modifications, you know, things, restrictions getting tighter and tighter. I still don't know what's going to happen. I wouldn't be surprised if more restrictions, or even if the season were to be canceled.
Here's hoping. It is not canceled.
Yeah, at least they're trying so far, you know? Like, they're trying everything they can, so we'll see. Coming up on 621 right now, still ahead for us. A lot of us have turned to ice cream to help us cool down over the last couple of weeks, but there's a new flavor out there causing some mixed reactions this morning. We'll talk about it coming up.
And ahead in our next half hour, with Dane County's mask order starting Monday, more mandates could be coming across the state and the Midwest. We're going to tell you where and how they compare to Dane County's. That's when News 3 Now This Morning continues.
News 3 Now Closed Captioning is sponsored by Wells Asphalt Paving.
Get the refrigerator you've always wanted now at the Brothers Main Big Deal Refrigerator Sale. Save big on the latest from GE. French doors, black stainless, and smart refrigerators, all with 0% financing up to 18 months. And you'll get our risk-free 30-day price satisfaction guarantee. We make it easy to be confident in your new refrigerator. It's the big deal refrigerator sale, with more selection, more savings, and more big confidence only at the Brothers Main, your local store for more since 1938.
Summer is here. It's time to grab the family and hit the open road. To make sure your trip is safe, Meineke is now offering free brake pads. Call your Madison area Meineke for details. Meineke Car Care Center is here to help.
The leadership development program is designed for people who at some point intend to become supervisors. It would open the doors for you for a lot of different types of positions where you're going to have people reporting to you. The number one reason I would say students should come to Blackhawk Tech is that they're going to get a great education from great instructors who understand, make the learning more applicable to them, a real quality education at a very reasonable cost.
Love, it's made to be shared.
America, we want to help get you back to it. And here's how, with the Ford Promise. Visit your Ford dealer, finance a new, certified pre-owned or used vehicle through Ford Credit, and if you lose your job, you can return it for up to 1 year from the day you bought it. You can also get 0% APR financing for 72 months across the Ford lineup. Let us help get you back to it with the Ford Promise.
Seeing the joy that people feel when they share a meal with family and friends, that's why we do this. The laughter of kids around the table, the thrill of families driving through for a treat, the delight of not having to cook, and instead letting us safely serve you. It all comes back to taking care of each other. And for that, we'll be here with your favorites and always a smile.
Garver. Garver.
Gather. Ping. Gathering.
Garver.
Gathering.
Garv.
Er.
Ping.
Garvering.
A socially responsible gathering where a maximum of 250 people enjoy thirst-quenching drinks, delicious food, and the arts in a safe, clean, and touchless outdoor environment.
Let's go garvering.
Visit thegarverfeedmail.com for dates and details starting June 11th.
Brought to you by News 3 Now, Madison Magazine, and the Garver Feed Mill.
All right, we always ask you to share your morning with us, and Kirby sent in this stunner over on our Facebook page. He actually pointed out that in the sky to the right of this picture, you can see a comet.
Wow.
Do you see that?
Yep.
Chris Stanford cannot.
My old
You're showing
man
your
eyes
age right now.
Do you need some readers?
Oh, my
God. Oh, my goodness.
I even have my contacts in.
Beautiful picture, though.
Kirby delivers. Okay, thanks for sending that in, Kirby. So what's your morning look like? Snap a picture, post it on our social media pages. Use the hashtag MyNews3Morning, and we'll show our favorites on the air.
Well, if you can't see this, Chris, you'll be able to taste this next one. A few weeks ago, we were talking about our favorite ice creams. Mine was Butter Brickle. Have you guys tried it yet?
No.
No.
Of course, I got some flack for that, but there is a new flavor that I'm wondering if anyone thinks sounds good. How about ketchup ice cream?
No.
Oh, boy.
Sold out.
Sold out. This is the real deal, guys. Heinz launched a do-it-yourself ice cream kit in Britain this month. There's no chocolate or strawberry. Here are your choices. Ketchup, mayo, barbecue sauce, and salad cream, which we found out is basically like putting mayo on top of lettuce, I guess.
Yum.
Heinz isn't selling the kits in the U.S., but if you're feeling adventurous, you can get those recipes online.
I love the Z in there. Heinz creams.
Creams.
Very clever.
I mean, I love my ice cream and I love my condiments, but they do not mix.
Hard pass.
Yeah.
No.
Not hot. Would not recommend.
Oh, my goodness. Well, Chris, we've had some good ice cream weather lately.
Yes, the weather has been hot, but we're starting to cool things off just a little bit. We'll be at 80 for lunchtime. We'll top out around 85 today, a little bit cooler this weekend.
Thank you very much, Chris Reese. Stay with us the last half hour. News 3 Now this morning, straight ahead.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Do you suffer from pain, stress, anxiety, depression? Hi there, my name is Tim O'Brien, owner of The Healthy Place. We carry one of the largest and most reputable selections of CBD products in southern Wisconsin. Our AMM CBD certified wellness consultants are on the cutting edge of CBD knowledge and can help you find the right potency for your relief.
Stop in this Friday and Saturday for 20% off on all CBD products.
Visit one of our four Madison-based locations, enjoy our live chat feature on our website, and check us out online with free shipping at findyourhealthyplace.com. The Healthy Place.
Relax, unwind, remain safe and secure in a new bath, shower, or walk-in tub from Mad City Baths, Wisconsin's number one ranked remodeler. Now during our summer spectacular sale, get a new bath or shower for only $49.95. Ask about great financing and call during this program for a free $100 Walmart or Amazon gift card with your in-home estimate. And be sure to ask about virtual online estimates.
Trips are better than daydreams. Experience the thrill of a bigger world in a Lexus high-performance vehicle. Visit your local Lexus dealer in person or online for exceptional offers at the Golden Opportunity Sales Event. Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer.
Wow, you ready?
Yeah, let me just grab my wallet.
Uh-oh. I've seen this before. Wallet way too big, skinny jeans too skinny.
I'll just carry it.
Before you break something, you should know you don't actually need a wallet. With BMO Harris, you can just take cash out with your phone. Or if you need to, you can pay them with Zelle.
That works?
Yeah. You're stuck, aren't you?
Smile.
Woo! Those jeans are way too tight.
That feeling you get when no wallet is no big deal. That's the BMO effect.
5 years, Affordable Dentures and Implants has created affordable access to dental care.
And we're proud to have helped millions of people improve their smiles.
Our number one priority is always being the health and the well-being of our patients and staff.
So, we're taking extra precautions to welcome you to a safe and clean environment.
Because we want you to go ahead and smile.
Affordable Dentures and Implants, we can't wait to see you.
Holding steady, the CDC keeping course despite comments from President Trump's administration. We'll tell you what new guidance you can expect and why it won't impact what the organization has already recommended.
The showers and thunderstorms of yesterday are bringing in cooler air for the weekend. We'll tell you what your highs will look like by Sunday.
This is News 3 Now This Morning.
Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Here we are at Friday, July 10th, 2020. You got big plans this weekend? You doing anything?
I do. I have a girlfriend's wedding tonight, and I have a little paddle date with some other girlfriends Saturday.
A paddle date?
A paddle date.
What's a paddle date?
What do you think a paddle date is? You know me well enough.
You go kayaking together?
Yes.
Paddle date.
It's going to be very cute.
It's adorable.
You're working on the house?
Yeah. And my wife and I are celebrating our anniversary this weekend.
You're getting a much-needed break from the family, from the kids. The wife's sister's coming into town, is that right?
Yeah, we got a babysitter, which is huge breaking news in the Stanford household.
Right.
So we hope you get a chance to get out and enjoy some of this beautiful weather that's in the forecast for this weekend. First, though, we want to tell you about coronavirus. Wisconsin continues to break its own coronavirus records, setting a new single-day increase with 739 new cases confirmed.
We're also continuing an upward trend in the percentage of positive cases. 5.7% of yesterday's tests came back positive. That's up from Wednesday's count by about a tenth of a percent. There were also four more deaths. At least 814 people have now died from coronavirus in Wisconsin. Just over 6,000 of the state's 34,000 confirmed cases are still active.
So, Vice President Mike Pence recently claimed that the CDC would update its school reopening plans. The organization's director, though, now says that won't be happening. Dr. Robert Redfield told Good Morning America the CDC will issue some more reference documents, but they won't be a revision of the guidelines that were previously released. So, President Trump, he's been criticizing the CDC's guidance, been calling it tough and expensive.
Dr. Fauci says we are still, quote, knee-deep in the first wave of the coronavirus pandemic. The nation's top infectious disease expert says this is due in part to some states reopening too fast. He's calling out Florida in particular. He says that state, which now has more than 232,000 cases, jumped over a couple of checkpoints and reopened too quickly. 48 hospitals across 26 counties have no more ICU beds available. Another 52 have 10% or less of their ICU available. About 70% of the U.S. population is pausing or rolling back reopening plans as cases continue to spread. No country in the world currently outpaces Florida or Arizona or South Carolina for new cases per capita. Take a look at this graphic from the New York Times. It shows new confirmed cases over the past week. 15 of the 25 regions listed here are states. The rest are countries.
So the World Health Organization is reinforcing what local health experts have been telling us for a while now, and that's to avoid crowded indoor spaces during the pandemic. They say the virus is still mainly being spread through close contact with infected people, but it's calling for more research into airborne transmission. The group's latest scientific report says airborne transmission has been reported at restaurants, nightclubs, churches, and gyms. Those spaces are typically crowded and not properly ventilated. Now, if you still don't want to take guidance from the world's leading health experts, maybe you'll listen to this guy.
But the main reason we want you to wear a mask is to protect me from you and the particles from your respiratory system from getting into my respiratory system. Everybody, this is a matter literally of life and death. And when I use the word literally, I mean literally a matter of life and death. So when you're out in public, please wear a mask. Thank you for joining me on Consider the Following.
So if you don't recognize him, that is Bill Nye the Science Guy. You may remember him from your childhood science classes. He's back on TikTok now. He did a two-part video on wearing a mask. He demonstrates the effectiveness of the different types of masks as he tries to blow out that candle on your screen. He says surgical masks and N95s are the most effective, but cloth masks work well too.
As Dane County prepares to roll out its mask mandate on Monday, the city of Milwaukee is now one step closer to implementing its own. The city's Public Safety and Health Committee passed the mandate during a special meeting last night. It'll now head to Mayor Tom Barrett's desk, who said he would sign it. The mandate would require anyone older than the age of 3 to wear a face covering outside if they're within 6 feet of a non-family or household member. Folks would also have to wear a face covering anytime they're inside a building that's open to the public.
The city of Milwaukee will be removing its Defund the Police mural today, citing traffic safety concerns. The Journal Sentinel reports city officials say the paint hides traffic lines and has been slippery because of the rain. The Department of Public Works says the decision is solely about safety. Protesters painted it on July 1st without the city's authorization right outside of City Hall. Since then, it's been repainted after someone changed Defund the Police to defend the police.
All right, 6:35 right now. Take a look at this new video into the newsroom this morning, guys, submitted by our very own Chris Reese and his friend Jonah. They were out storm chasing last night. Look at those cloud formations. Now, Chris, where did you take this video? I know you were kind of all over the viewing area.
Yeah, that was just northeast of Sun Prairie. Are we able to take that full screen? I don't know if we are. But that was just northeast of Sun Prairie as those storms began to get even closer. There was a lot of wind associated with that one. And that storm in particular, that was scary.
The lightning was just incredible.
Yes, it really was. And then the wind that came out ahead of it was the best adrenaline rush I've had in a long time. I can say that much. We saw some showers out there at least earlier on this morning, but those are all getting ready to move out of the area as we speak. In fact, they're doing so. We have a couple of showers just towards the north and east of town. A lot of this is closer towards the Milwaukee metro now. Then down south of town, Janesville towards Milton, and then working its way towards Whitewater. That's another shower that we have in the area. Otherwise, things continue to clear on out for us. These showers, thunderstorms, going to be working their way over Lake Michigan and then eventually out of the upper Midwest as a whole. Here's how things look outside right now. Still a little bit hazy. The airport is reporting a few raindrops, but I can tell you on radar, a lot of that is going by the wayside. Winds are out of the west and northwest at about 3 miles per hour. 68 in Janesville right now. 68 for Mineral Point. Madison, of course, at 67. Dew points are still into the 60s, so there's still a moisture content to the air that you're going to feel as you step outside, but the air will be drier, especially as we go through the rest of this afternoon and into your weekend as well. 80 degrees by lunchtime. We'll top out at 85 today. Overnight tonight, we're cooling right back down into the mid-60s. I can't rule out a little shower or two possible, especially towards the south and west. Most of your Saturday is going to be dry. But once again, I can't rule out a little shower. Temperatures only top out at 85. But then our pattern is one that starts to get a little bit cooler and still unsettled as we move into next week. Here's what we're watching right now. Watch all this cooler air starts to move in from the north. Eventually, though, as we move towards next week, we're on the battle zone. Cooler air towards the north, warmer air towards the south. That keeps things active. That's why we have storm chances in that forecast for Tuesday and Wednesday in particular. Expect some temperature changes in the forecast as we get closer, because we're going to be trying to figure out where exactly Madison stands. Are we on the warm side or on the cool side? That's what happens with the battle zone. Either way, we go from 81 on Sunday, which will be the coolest day we have had this month and since some point in June, and then we're back into the low 90s by next weekend.
81 going to feel like a dream.
Oh, I can't wait.
Oh, perfect timing, too. All right, Chris, thank you. Take a look at this new video just into the newsroom this morning. 28-year-old Philip Blank says he believes he was put on this earth to protect people. Well, that is exactly what he did when he caught a 3-year-old boy who was thrown from the balcony of a burning apartment in Phoenix, Arizona. Blanks is a former high school football star and a retired U.S. Marine, and now he can add hero to the list. Here's what he had to say about what happened in those moments.
He was twirling like a helicopter, and just when I caught it, it was just like, it was lightweight. He was lightweight, honestly. Like his head perfectly fell right here in my elbow. Body, like everything was intact except for his foot, unfortunately. But the main thing is that he got out alive.
Yeah, he said he was at the apartment complex to meet up with a friend for an early morning workout when he heard screaming. Without hesitation, he ran and dove to catch the boy. A local news report says the boy and his 8-year-old sister were hurt and their mom died. He plans on keeping up with the kids and the father to help them as best as they can. to recover.
Oh, that is a miraculous save there by that man. Just incredible to watch. Your heart just...
It does. Kinda,
it skips a beat.
Two stories there, too. I mean, that's a long ways.
You know, hero indeed.
We're at 6:39 now. 2 years ago today, the city of Sun Prairie was forever changed when an explosion leveled part of its downtown and killed one of its firefighters.
Tonight, the community will take another step forward in its process to rebuild. Christina Lorre is live this morning with more on what's happening today. Good morning, Christina.
Good morning, everyone. A new sign of strength, resiliency, and respect will be unveiled later tonight here in Sun Prairie. It's hard to believe it's been 2 years since Captain Corey Barr was killed in an explosion. And tonight, a memorial and statue in his honor will be dedicated here at the fire station in town. That's where we are this morning. And we're joined by Aaron Oppenheimer. He's the city administrator. And Aaron, I want to make this interview about Corey. You knew him. What was he like for those of us who never met him?
Yes, he was somebody that was out in the community. He was a business owner in the community, a firefighter since he was 18 years old, somebody that you saw different places out and about in the community, always giving back and being a part of things.
Wow, he was the owner of the Bar House here in town. It was a well-known establishment.
Yes.
He also left behind two little girls.
Yes.
What would you want them to know about the qualities that their dad had?
Their dad was a first responder, somebody who saved lives the evening of July 10th, 2018, somebody that was giving, fun to be around, had a great sense of humor.
That's great. That it makes me smile knowing that he left behind such a legacy. He also left behind his wife, Abby.
Yes.
She's going to be out here tonight. What will she be doing?
Abby's been so strong during these events, all these public events, and has been there and spoke at them. She'll be speaking again tonight, talking about Corey and just how the family has been dealing with his loss and their memories.
And so she'll be out here in front of the fire station starting at 6 o'clock tonight. There's going to be a special ceremony to unveil a new memorial in Captain Corey Barr's honor. Again, that ceremony starts at 6 o'clock. Masks are required if you want to attend. The city's going to do their best to try to separate people into groups of 25 or less, but it's still going to be pretty close quarters. You won't be able to keep as big of a distance as I was from Aaron this morning. We will also be live streaming that ceremony up on our Channel 3000 Facebook page if you can't make it out here in person but still want to pay your respects on this two-year milestone. Chris, Leah.
Yeah, Day Sun Prairie, you'll never forget. Thank you, Christina.
All right, let's take a look at the roads on this Friday morning. If you're heading out right now, we start with a look at Dane County, where there are no traffic incidents to speak of. Beltline looking so far so good. Rock County also looking good so far. Looks like the slowdowns on the interstate have moved on. Only 25 minutes from Janesville to the Beltline. Let's take a live look outside as we kick off the weekend. Chris is talking about a little relief in the forecast. He's going to have that news coming up. You're watching News 3 Now this morning. We thank you for that, and we'll be right back after this.
The OBGYN team at Associated Physicians wants you to know that we are here to focus on you. Call us for an appointment today at 233-9746.
I am crushing this to-do list.
Let me see. Smart home upgrade?
Mm-hmm.
Home gym?
Check.
What about the window siding and doors?
Cross something important off your list. Free installation on all windows, siding, and doors. And no interest for 1 year. The biggest sale of the year is here.
Free installation ends soon. Call now.
For quality windows, siding, and doors, call 866 for Feltco.
You wash your cars and clothes and canines. You wash your cars.
Car since you were 8 policy from American Family Insurance.
Insure carefully. Dream fearlessly.
Only Steinhoffel sells more Tempur-Pedic than anyone else. And right now, get $300 in Steinhoffel's cash with any Tempur-Pedic. We are Wisconsin's number one Tempur-Pedic retailer.
At the Brothers Main, we're on a mission to deliver more brands, more selection, and more savings on more appliances. See for yourself at the Brothers Main, your local store for more since 1938.
America, we want to help get you back to it. And here's how, with the Ford Promise. Visit your Ford dealer. Finance a new, certified pre-owned or used vehicle through Ford Credit. And if you lose your job, you can return it for up to 1 year from the day you bought it. You can also get 0% APR financing for 72 months across the Ford lineup. Let us help get you back to it with the Ford Promise.
Madison's not happy treating people differently because of their race.
I've learned when I've been out reporting on the front lines that everyone is impacted differently, but it's also important to take some time to not judge people and to understand where they're coming from and why they might be angry or why they might be sad.
This is our opportunity. You do see the best in some people coming out.
This time feels different. This time, I think a real conversation may begin.
So a lot of us are spending a lot more time at home to slow the spread of COVID-19. And we're spending a lot more time hanging around the pantry, too,
I'd say. Yeah, quarantine 15. Yeah. It's a thing. There's one particular comfort food that a lot of us have been picking at. It's chocolate. Sales have been increasing since mid-March, when many of us started staying home. In the roughly 17 weeks since, people bought $3.7 billion with a B dollars worth of chocolate. That's a more than 6% increase from the same time last year.
Sounds like a lot of chocolate.
I'm definitely contributing to that number.
Yeah, you're raiding your s'more stash.
So briefly, yeah, we always have a s'more stash for our camping. We always forget to take it camping, so after dinner, you find me snacking on an entire Hershey's bar, maybe two, couple of marshmallows on the side. Because Zach is...
Do you break it apart and eat it, or do you just, like, take a full bite?
Oh, yeah, because I think that I'll just eat a piece of it, and then I'll walk back and have three more pieces.
You can never have just one.
No, you can't. You can't have that stuff in the house.
It's tough. It's like you go into the store, too, and I know they do this for a reason, but, like, even this week I walk in, they've got all the cookies, like, right when you walk in, and I'm like, I came here to get a salad. Sweets are out there, and it's like, I've got the biggest sweet tooth, too, so it's like, I see, like, a chocolate chip cookie, and it's like, well, I gotta get
that.
Did you get the salad?
I did get the salad.
All right, good for
you. You know what? It was the best salad ever. I'm glad I did it.
Balance.
It
had
cookies sprinkled in it.
I did go for some ice cream after that, though, so.
No, I that's the one thing. It doesn't get me, because I don't like a bunch of sweets and chocolate. Like, ugh. I don't.
But you're like probably the spice guy, though.
I am the spice guy. If it's got spice in it, I am using it. In fact, that's the aisle where you get me. It's the spice aisle. Those things are so expensive.
Oh, yeah.
But the food tastes good. I can tell you that.
Well, that weather
has been
quite spicy lately. I know you like that.
Yeah, the weather has been spicy, but this is not the kind that I like. We need to tone it down. We're in the process of doing that, though, as we get towards the weekend, especially. Get this. We're already starting to see some of that sunshine out there as the rain begins to pull away. This has been Doppler track over the past 3 hours. You see those final showers moving on out of here. That's going to be working its way towards Michigan and out of the upper Midwest altogether. But I will say, this shot's beautiful. I like looking at it. 67 is the temperature in Madison right now. The airport's still reporting a few raindrops. I suspect that that just needs an update, because things should be dry for all of the Madison area right now. Janesville at 68. Lone Rock is at 67. We're at 71 down in Kenosha. Here's what to expect as you look ahead, though. 74 by 8 o'clock, 78 by 10, 80 by 12. We'll top out at 85 today.
Ooh, all right, Chris Reese, thank you. Coming up in the morning sprint, the next time you go buy your cup of coffee, you could be required to wear a mask. We'll tell you why.
And looking at who's three today, thanks to Adeline's parents for sending in her picture. Happy birthday, Adeline. And to all the kids celebrating their birthdays with us today, thank you. We'll be right back.
Look Who's Three is sponsored by Three Bears Resort Indoor Water Park and Conference Center in Warrens, Wisconsin.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell, inventor of My Pillow. Just like you, I had problems sleeping. I tried every pillow out there and nothing worked. 15 years ago, I invented My Pillow. It took me 2 years to develop because I wanted to have everything you would ever want in a pillow. I made sure that you could adjust my patented fill so you could have the exact support you need as an individual, regardless of your sleep position. I also wanted a pillow that would last, so I made My Pillow machine washable and dryable. I backed My Pillow with a 10-year warranty and a 60-day money-back guarantee. Not only that, I do all my own manufacturing in my home state of Minnesota.
I really like the fact that it was made in the USA. I think that USA products are a better quality product. I've tried a lot of other pillows, and nothing's worked like My Pillow.
I'm interrupting this commercial right now to give you deep discounts, not just on My Pillows, but also my mattress topper sheets and so much more. For example, you can get body pillows, regular $89.99, now only $29.99, or My Pillow dog beds for as low as $19.99 with your promo code.
I used to think that sheets were just sheets. I got the Giza Dream sheets. They are the most comfortable sheets I've ever had.
The Go Anywhere pillow is so easy to just roll up and take anywhere I want to go.
Go Anywhere pillow is really comfortable, so that's what I really like. It's nice and supportive, and it's nice and small.
The My Pillow topper, for the first time, has enabled me to have a cool night's sleep. I'm able to go to bed and just get rest.
That's 3 inches of wonderful that's in the My Pillow mattress topper. It's just like a firm cloud.
My Pillow helps me get a good night's sleep so I can do my job in the morning.
Go to MyPillow.com to get deep discounts, not just on My Pillows, but so much more. For example, you get body pillows, regular $89.99, now only $29.99, or My Pillow dog beds for as low as $19.99 with your promo code.
For the best night's sleep in the whole wide world, visit MyPillow.com.
Medical bills, missed time at work, life-changing injuries, household expenses. When you're the victim of an accident, it can feel like the weight of the entire world is on your shoulders. But we've dedicated our personal injury law firm to help take this crippling burden off your back. Havish, Havish, and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
Help get you back to it. And here's how, with the Ford Promise. Visit your Ford dealer, finance a new, certified pre-owned or used vehicle through Ford Credit, and if you lose your job, you can return it for up to 1 year from the day you bought it. You can also get 0% APR financing for 72 months across the Ford lineup. Let us help get you back to it with the Ford Promise.
Download the Channel 3000 First Warn Weather app today.
6:52, time for the morning sprint.
Wisconsin continues to break its own coronavirus record, setting a new single-day increase with 739 new confirmed cases. We're also continuing an upward trend in the percentage of positive cases. 5.7% of yesterday's test came back positive. That's up from Wednesday's count by about a tenth of a percent. There were also four more deaths. At least 814 people have now died from coronavirus in Wisconsin. More than 6,000 of the state's 34,000 confirmed cases are still active.
A reminder, Dane County's mask mandate goes into effect after the weekend. Starting Monday, everybody over the age of 5 will have to wear a mask anytime they're in a building that isn't their own home. That includes all businesses, healthcare settings, waiting in line, and public transportation. We have more information on that mandate up on channel3000.com, and we'll be answering your questions and looking into the implications of the mandate all day Monday.
If you plan on picking up a coffee at Starbucks next week, you'll need to wear a mask. All the company's 9,000 stores will enforce a mask mandate starting Wednesday. Starbucks says customers who refuse to wear a mask inside can still order from the drive-thru, curbside pickup, or delivery. For Starbucks locations in Dane County, though, you'll be required to wear a mask starting Monday because of the countywide mandate.
New data shows women and people of color are disproportionately reliant on unemployment insurance. Women make up two-thirds of the lowest paid workers in the U.S., and non-white workers are far more likely to be paid poverty-level wages than their white peers. As Politico reports, this makes these groups especially vulnerable if Congress decides not to renew expanded benefits. This includes a $600 weekly payment, which is set to expire at the the end of the month.
More than 1,000 TSA employees have tested positive for coronavirus since the pandemic began. The Washington Post reports almost all of them are security officers who have continued to work and screen passengers at airports through the pandemic. Air travel numbers are still lower than usual, but they're starting to climb again. Nearly 2.7 million people flew over the holiday weekend. TSA has 50,000 screening officers total.
Wearing a mask doesn't just save lives, it can also save the economy. A new analysis by Goldman Sachs finds if there was a national mandate for all Americans to wear masks, it would keep us from reducing the gross domestic product by $1 trillion or 5%. If more people wear masks, the transmission rate is lower. That allows cities and counties to open more quickly, which would prevent those hits to the GDP.
Credit card debt in the U.S. is shrinking during the coronavirus recession. It's now below $3 trillion for the first time in nearly 3 years. The Federal Reserve says it's down by $24 billion in May and down by $100 billion since hitting a record high in February. This didn't happen during the last two economic downturns, but with fewer social gatherings and opportunities to spend money, financial strategists say the new data makes sense.
Breaking overnight, Madison police need your help in finding this woman. Police say Mary Benham walked out of Meritor Hospital yesterday afternoon around 4:30. She doesn't have access to a cell phone or car, and there are some concerns that she may be unsafe on her own. She was wearing a dark blue jacket or sweater, a flowery short skirt, light gray pants, and blue leather flats. She was also carrying a purse and a plastic bag. If you've seen her, you're asked to call Madison Police.
The city of Sun Prairie will unveil a memorial statue today on the second anniversary of the downtown explosion. The statue will be a firefighter holding Captain Corey Barr's helmet. Barr died responding to the gas leak that caused the explosion. The community raised more than $29,000 to make that memorial happen.
6:55, final look at the roads this Friday morning as you head out the door. You're in good shape so far. There's a look at Dane County right now. No crashes or major incidents to speak of. Rock County also looking good this morning. That's your first warn traffic.
Sunshine returns as we go through today. It's also going to be a little bit cooler and a little bit less humid. This is lunchtime today. We'll be at 80 as that rain begins to pull on out of south central Wisconsin. We top out at 85. Tomorrow and into Sunday, we really start to see kind of the impacts of this cooler air that's working its way on into town. In fact, on Sunday, we're going to spend most of the day in the 70s, and then we'll breach the low 80s for that high into the afternoon. Now, next week, we start to get into what I call the battle zone, where we have the cooler air towards the north, the warmer air towards the south. That's going to keep at least a couple of rain chances around. But you see that dip before we bounce right back up into the low 90s. That extended forecast is one I like.
Thank you very much, Chris Reese. We like it too. Thanks for joining us this morning, folks. Have a great weekend. We'll see you back here Monday.